So I had to get a nuclear medicine test done, and you know they use radioactive isotope. Now I've worked around radiation over 30 years, my whole life. I wear dosimeters every day, but this is different than being injected with radiation. So for my scan, I was injected with technetium 99M, and that is for testing at brain, lungs, hearts, scans like that. It's very radioactive, and I was reading online, I got some notes here, that half-life of technetium is 6 hours. That means if the dose is 10,000 in 6 hours, it should be 5,000. Well, since I do have a Geiger counter, I thought I'd somehow piece together a video. I don't know how it's going to turn out. And I also read somewhere that after 24 hours that you're safe. I don't believe that. In this video, we're going to see how long I'm radioactive for. This is a great little Geiger counter. I'll put the link in the description below. It shows click per minute. Also has a dose down here. And background clicks per minute is about 5 to 10. I even have this cute little radiation card here. Look at that. Oh, this thing does work. Check this out. You can buy both from Amazon. Somehow we'll piece this video together, and let's go. So I just had a nuclear medicine test, and have you ever wondered, are you really radioactive? And let's see for how long and how far you are radioactive for. Let me get my Geiger counter. I'm going to have LeeAnn bring over my little Geiger counter. Link is in the description below. See if this thing really works. This is not happy. So we're going to test like 1 hour, 2 hours after injection time. Let's see what the distance is. Because remember the inverse square law. Time, distance, shielding when it comes to radiation. Let me walk away and see. Let me get a roller. Here I am, 3 feet away. Now I am 48 inches away. Oh dear. I am now 72 inches away. 72 inches away. Check that out. Man, am I radioactive. But I don't know, let's see what the half-life is of this. And we're going to check back in an hour or two or four and see what the half-life is. Crazy.
2150.
It is now 4:15 p.m. I got injected around 9:30 this morning, so that's more than 6 hours, which is what they say the half-life is. And my little Geiger counter here, usually the background radiation is about 15 to 16 clicks. So compare that to what this was reading. So let's go ahead and turn this on. We'll do the up close, and then we'll do a 3 foot, and then we'll do a 6 foot. It's gone down a little bit. Is it half of what it was before? I don't remember what it was before. Let's go ahead and check out 3 foot. This is our reading at 36 inches. Gotta zoom in with one hand. All right, post any question you have in the comments below. And post if you wanna know if something's radioactive. I could make videos and say, is that radioactive? Are bananas radioactive? I don't know. Okay, let's check out 6 foot now. Here I am, I'm at 72 inches, 6 foot away. And there's our clicks from it. Compare that before. What should we do next? I think we'll do a 24 hour check. All right. Post your comments below. What do you think is radioactive? Is that spam right there radioactive? Maybe we should do a video about that. Comment below. It's now been a little over 24 hours since the injection. If you read internet, they're like, most of this is out of your system after 24 hours. Do you believe that? If half-life, it's not out of your system, you know. Every 6 hours, half, half, half. Let's find out with the Geiger counter. Let's see here. You hear those clicks? Let's zoom in. I'm getting around 3,500 clicks per minute. Right down here. This is the dose reading. Let's check the distance. Let's do again the 3 foot and the 6 foot distance. Okay, here's the reading at 36 inches. Still says it's high. Let's go back to 6 feet. Although it is much lower than yesterday, but I'm still radioactive. I'm back at 72 inches. Is that about the same reading as 3 feet? There you go. Let's check. I don't know if we're gonna do like a 32-hour update. Maybe we'll do. We gotta keep this going. We're gonna do a 48-hour update, and let's see how that goes. Look at that. It's crazy.
Day two. It's 48 hours since my injection. And if you read on Google Internet, it says you about 24 hours out of your system. That's a lie. That's not true. Turn the Geiger counter again. Here we go. 48 hours later. Now we know the background clicks are about 12 to 15, so that's not background radiation. All right, it keeps averaging out so that numbers go up and down. So here we are. We'll call it 250 clicks per minute. Let's do the 3 foot and six. Let's do the 3 feet, 6 feet test.
Here we are. I'm at 36 inches, and I'm not affecting anything. So obviously at 6 feet, remember the inverse square law. Time distance shielding. So the distance is very important. Now over here at 3 feet, 6 feet, and 3 feet, it did not register 24 hours later. That's good.
Don't worry, the video is not over until we get back to normal background levels. You can see here we are still high. So let's do a 72 hour update. All right. This is day three, 72 hours. It's technically about 75 hours because I was busy this morning. Let's just see. Am I no longer radioactive? We are just getting picking up background clicks right now. There you go, 72 hours, no longer radioactive. So, is that longer than you thought? It was longer than I thought, okay? This is normal background clicks, like I said. Normally outside we'll get about 12 to 15 clicks per minute. There, we are good. What did you think of this? Did we learn anything? So anyways, comment below. What do you think of the verdict? Is 72 hours clear? Day one, day two, very radioactive. That was crazy. Click over here, watch another one of our videos. Comment. I'd love to hear your comments on this about how radioactive, man, I was. Yeah, that was insane.